So let us discuss case number one, where the object is at infinity. When the object is at infinity in front of a convex lens, so where is the mesh formed? Let us see. This is the convex lens, optical center, this is F1, 2F1, F2, 2F2. Now, the object is at infinity, so from infinity the parallel rays will come and fall on the lens, and according to rule number 1, which says that any ray parallel to principal axis incident on a convex lens after refraction passes through the focus on the other side of the lens. So these rays will pass through the focus F2. Since these are the two real rays, so real image will be formed at point F2, that is the second focus. So position of image is at F2. Now, what is its size? Size of image, it is point size or highly diminished. This image will be of point size or highly diminished. Now nature of image. As I told you that if the real rays meet after refraction, then the real image is formed. If the virtual rays meet after refraction or reflection, then virtual image is formed. So here real rays are meeting, so real image will be formed and inverted also. So real and inverted image will be formed. So we have seen that when an object is at infinity, the image is formed at F2, its size is point size, real and inverted image is formed. Now case number 2, when the object is beyond 2F1, is beyond 2F1. Let us see in this case where is the image formed, what is its nature and what is its size. So case number 2, when the object is beyond 2F1, so this is the optical center, this is F1, this point 2F1, F2, 2F2. Now object is beyond 2F1, means somewhere outside 2F1, not at infinity, between infinity and 2F1. Now take one ray that is parallel to principal axis. This ray after refraction, according to rule number 1, will pass through focus F2, and we can take any other ray. That ray we can take from the optical center. So if we take the another ray from the optical center, so this ray will go as it is without deviation. This ray will not deviate, it will go as it is, and you observe that these rays after refraction meet at this point. So image will be formed between F2 and 2F2. So position of the image between F2 and 2F2. Now size, you observe that this image size is smaller than the object size. So image is diminished in size. It is diminished in size. And what about the nature? You observe the real rays again after refraction meeting. So real and inverted image will be formed. So this was case number 2. Now case number 3, where the object is at 2f1 itself, that is, it is at 2f1. In that case, let us see where is the image formed. So in this case, this is optical center, this is F1, this point 2F1, it is F2, and this point it is 2F2. So in this case, again let us suppose this is the object at 2F1 itself. So let us take one ray again parallel to principal axis. So you know that according to rule number 1, after refraction will pass through F2, and we can take another ray, that is through the optical center. So this ray after refraction will, go as it is without deviation. Now you suppose that these two rays are meeting at this point. So the image is formed at 2F2. So position of the image is at, it is formed at 2F2. And what is size? You observe that the size of the object and size of the image is same. So image will be of same size. And real inverted. Real, because real rays are meeting, you observe that tip of this arrow is below, so it is inverted. So real and inverted image will be formed. Now case number 4. Case number 4, when the object is, between F1 and 2F1. So when the object is between F1 and 2F1, the image, we will see that between F1 and 2F1. So we will see that the image is formed. This is optical center, it is F1, this is 2F1. It is F2, and this is 2F2. Now object is between F1 and 2F1, is anywhere between F1 and 2F1. So let us take it here. And now, as a ray, take one ray parallel to principal axis. So this ray after refraction will pass through F2. The focus, and take another ray, that is through the optical center. So this ray, as you know that after refraction will not deviate, will go as it is. So you observe that these two rays are meeting at this point. So image will be formed beyond 2F2. So position of the image is beyond 2F2. And what is size? You observe that the size of the object is the size of the image. So image is larger than the object. So image is enlarged. Image is enlarged. Now, what is the nature? You observe that the real rays are meeting, so real image will be formed. Now tip of the arrow in the image is below, so the inverted image will be formed. Now case number 5, where the object is at F1 itself. Object is at F1, that is focus, is at F1, that is focus itself. So let us draw the ray diagram for this. Optical center F1, 2F1, F2, 2F2. Now the object is at the focus itself here. So take again one ray parallel to principal axis. So what would happen to this ray? This ray will pass through the focus F2 after refraction. Now take any other ray that is through the optical center. So this ray will go as it is without deviation. You know rule number 3, any ray through the optical center, so it will go as it is without deviation. And you observe that these two rays are parallel rays, so they go to infinity. You know that these rays, parallel rays, meet at the infinity. So where are the rays meeting? At the infinity. So image will be formed where? The image will be formed at infinity. So what is the position of the image? Position of the image at infinity. Position of image will be at infinity. Now what is its size? You know that since these rays are meeting at infinity, so below the principal axis you draw the arrow, so it will go to infinity. So highly enlarged image is formed. What is the size of the image? It is highly enlarged. Highly enlarged. Highly enlarged image will be formed. Now we talk about the nature of the image. So again you observe that these two refracted rays are real. So real image will be formed. Below the principal axis it is formed, so real and inverted image will be formed. Now case number 6. Now the last case where the object can be kept, the object can be kept between F1 and O. Now let us draw the ray diagram for that. When the object is between O and F1. So let us see where is the image formed and what is the nature and size of the image. So in this case, this is F1, this is O. Now this is 2F1. Here it is F2, this is 2F2. Now the object is kept in between O and F1, so not in between O and F1 doesn't mean that midpoint, anywhere between F1 and O. So let us put the object here. Now again take one ray parallel to principal axis. So this ray after refraction will pass through the focus F2. So this is the refracted ray. Now take another ray as earlier through the optical center. So this ray, as you know that as it is, go without any deviation. Now you observe that these two rays which are obtained after refraction, they are going away from each other. They are not parallel, they are going away from each other. So if these two rays are going away from each other, so they will never meet. It means no image will be formed. Yes, no real image will be formed. But if we elongate these rays in the opposite direction, if we elongate these rays in the opposite direction, so we will find that if we elongate these rays in the opposite direction, so we will find that these rays are supposed to meet at this point. So the image is formed, but not the real image. We have elongated the ray by dotted line. These are the virtual rays. So virtual image will be formed. Okay. So where is the image formed? Image will be formed on the same side of the lens. So position of the image will be on the same side of the lens. On the same side of the lens where the object is. Now what is size? You observe that image is larger than the object, so we get the enlarged image. Image is enlarged. Now we talk about the nature. So you observe that virtual rays are meeting, so virtual image is formed, not the real image. Virtual image will be formed, and erect virtual, you observe that it is the, this image is above the principal axis, not the below the principal axis, so erect image will be formed. So virtual and erect image is formed. Virtual and erect image will be formed. So let us summarize the cases of image formation by convex lens. We observe that for 5 cases we get the real and inverted image, but for the one case when the object is between F1 and O, then we get the virtual and erect image. So this was all about the image formed by the convex lens. Next time we will discuss the image formed by concave lens. Thank you.